Hello, everybody. Man, it is good to be here today because I'm sharing with you a little bit more of a vulnerable post and video because I want to talk to you about the last 3 years of my business. And this isn't something that for me is easy to share, one, because just personally, like, it's never fun to think about areas where you need to grow. And for me, I like to focus on my areas of strength and really lean into them. But if we are going to be excellent entrepreneurs who don't just make a profit, but actually make an impact and leave legacies, we have to really consider how to shore up those places where we're a little weak or still a little rough around the edges. And so I want to tell you what I feel are my three biggest mistakes in the last 3 years of my business. And if you can relate to this, please let me know, because I want you to know primarily you're not alone in this, in these feelings. And I know for the first couple years of my business, at least definitely in the second year of my business, I felt like I was missing something. Like, I didn't know what other people were doing and I couldn't figure it out. And I was like, I'm a smart person. I know I can do this. And so if that's you, you can do this. You're a smart person. And so let's get right into it. What it all boiled down to was mindset issues. And there were three specific ones that I didn't even know I had mindset issues when I first started on this entrepreneurial journey. And the very first one was something I have now learned to call shiny object syndrome, or sparkly object syndrome. And really, it's this thing where you're going down your path and you know what you want to do, you know what you want to help people with, and all of a sudden you see somebody and they're doing it really well, and you're like, oh, I could do that too. And why don't I throw this in there and offer this to my people as well? And then, oh, I really like what she's doing over there, and let me just push that in there as well. And while it's okay to get inspiration from other people, you know, shiny object syndrome really looks like kind of dropping what you're doing well and going after what somebody else is doing well, and not considering whether or not this is something that's within my area of strengths to do. And so that was the first thing that I really struggled with. Was I really admired a lot of women online, and I was like, oh, I would love to be able to support women to do X, or I would love to support women to do Y, and why not do both? And so that was one of the places where I really struggled a lot, probably my first year in business. My second year in business, man, oh man, did I have scarcity mindset. And the thing about scarcity mindset, especially when it comes to investing in yourself or investing in your business, is it's rooted in fear, right? That there's not enough to go around. There's not enough clients to go around. There's not enough money to go around. There's not enough time to go around. Scarcity can look different for different people. And for me, I had time, but I didn't have a lot of money. And I wasn't confident that there were enough women who would want to work with me. And so scarcity mindset, financially, I just wanted to do it all myself. And I really had solopreneur mindset. And I thought that that was an admirable thing. Like, hey, I can build this business all by myself. Kudos to me. And you know what? I didn't get very far. I got places and I got clients, but I didn't get very far. And I burned myself out. Which leads me to my third hustle mindset mistake. And when I'm talking about hustle mindset, I'm not talking about working hard. I believe that you're a hard worker. I know that I'm a hard worker. In fact, I have tendencies that border on like workaholism because I love what I do. And so it's hard for me to set it down. And so hustle mindset, really what I'm saying by saying hustle mindset is that it's a little bit rooted in the scarcity of like, I've got to get it, got to get it, got to get it. It's a place of desperation. It's a place of just getting to the next client and not really thinking beyond that. If I can just grow my list to 100, if I can just get my Facebook group to 300, if I can just land that next client, and you're just hustling to the next thing. And while I'm all for taking action and small actions that build momentum and doing that quickly and effectively, and that's all well and good, hustle leaves us drained. and it doesn't leave us excited and passionate, and it burns us out. So what I prefer to do is lean into persistence and consistency. And so if you're experiencing or can relate to any of these mindset traps, here's how you can overcome each one of them. So with shiny object syndrome, here's what I want you to do. I want you to declare objective truth. Objective meaning it's not subjective. It's not your truth. It's not my truth. It is objective truth. And the way you get that is by doing some tests, some personality tests or strengths tests. And so you start declaring that objective truth about your reality. So for example, I always keep this book handy. It's called Strength Finders 2.0 by Tom Rath. And this has, it changed my life in 2014, and it sent me down my entrepreneurial journey. I recommend this. It's $13 on Amazon. I like the hard copy. You can get a Kindle version. Either way, there's a code for you to take a test. It's Pew Research backed, really good stuff. If you're struggling to know what your strengths are, do that. And that way you can avoid shiny object syndrome and such shiny object mindset and do what it is that you have been created and called and purposed to do. Okay. And so when you know your strengths, it's way easier to stay in your own lane. And you know what? It's okay to want to emulate people and admire people who do things well, but ultimately you want people emulating you because you're doing things well and you're leaning into your own strengths. It's always attractive when people are operating in their strengths, always. Okay, scarcity mindset. So spreading money makes money, right? I can't remember who said it, but I will always remember this saying of like, money's like manure. If you keep it in a large pile, it stinks. And if you spread it around, it grows things, right? And so if you're wanting your business to grow, if you are wanting to grow, you need to spread that money out in your business. And even if you don't have very much that you're starting with right now, that's okay. Do what you can with what you have. And you know what? Don't be afraid to invest, because you're always going to learn something. And if you need support, get the support. If you're struggling with your copywriting, hire a copywriter or hire a copywriting mentor or a voice branding coach. If you're struggling with ads, hire someone to help you with Google ads or Twitter ads or Facebook ads or Pinterest ads. Wherever your space is, get support around that thing. And maybe it's only for 1 month and it gives you that boost that you need. And you know what? You just have to find a way to make it happen. If you're an entrepreneur, you have to be autonomous and figure out a way to get things done. You know, if you need the support, sell an old table lamp on Facebook Marketplace. Right? Go dog sit for your neighbor. Or maybe you, I don't know, maybe you do someone's wedding makeup over the weekend. Maybe you're in the beauty industry and you make a little bit of cash on the weekend, right? In addition to your business. Now, this isn't something you're doing all the time. It's these little boosts that you're wanting in your business for actions that have a profitable return on that investment. Profitable ROI is what that's called. And so get the support you need. Find solutions. There's for every challenge, there is a solution. So make that happen. And lastly, the hustle mindset. I had to make a choice about how I wanted to live my life and how I wanted to leave a legacy and how I wanted people to remember me. People started saying to me, Brittany, I'd love to hang out with you, but I know you're busy and I didn't want to bother you. Brittany, I wanted to call you about something, but I know that you're busy and, you know, I didn't want to interrupt your day because I know you're working with clients. And that really started to eat at me, and I didn't like it. So I stopped being busy, and what being busy meant looked like hustling. And I got a plan and I stuck to it and I started trusting the process. And, you know, hustling doesn't mean that I don't work hard, and stopping the hustle in your mind especially is not gonna be mean that you're not working hard or you're not serving clients well or not showing up well. But man, does that experience feel less draining, and it's so much less fear-based. It's more hope-based. And I know that that's something I need more of, and I imagine you need more of, because we're all humans, right? And so, you know, all of these have been a work in progress, and there are still times where I'm like, oh man, she does that so well, or he does that so well. I'd love to be able to do that. And you know, shiny object syndrome doesn't mean that it never happens to you. It is a mastering what you do with that admiration and how you choose to pick and choose, like, you know what, I really love how they do this. I think I'm gonna take this little thing about how they worded something. I really liked that. I think I'm gonna include that in my next video. Or the scarcity mindset. Sometimes that means like pushing yourself to invest in something, even though it's scary, having courage to take a risk, even though all you get out of it is maybe a lesson learned. And so, you know, I and to this day still struggle with the hustle versus like, and what I mean by hustle, like stopping working at a certain time of the day and setting the work down and coming back to it the next day, because I love what I do. I love working with women and seeing their dreams become a reality and watching light bulbs go off in their heads and just, you know, seeing them excited because now they have hope and they have a plan and they know what to do next. That's hard for me to set down because I also get caught up in the emotion of it and I get excited with my clients. And so those are my three mindset mistakes in the first 3 years of my business. Man, it has been a journey. I would love to hear from you about whether or not, which one of these you struggle with, because I know we all struggle with them, but in this season, what are you needing to set down? What are you needing to work on in your mindset? Is it number one, shiny object syndrome? Number two, scarcity mindset? Or three, hustle mindset? I'd love to support you as you make those shifts and changes. And but I'd love to know, where are you? Because I've been there. A lot of us have been there who are in the online entrepreneur industry. And so I'd love to help you get through that season. That's it for today. Man, y'all have an awesome and productive rest of your week. And I will see you around here in the Facebook community. Bye, guys.